Hello everyone, this is Muskan Singh. Today I am going to talk about the topic Judicial Separation. Judicial separation is a provision under Indian law which gives the marriage a second chance by not ending the marital ties between a husband and a wife, but allowing them to stay apart with the same legal status of a husband and wife. Judicial separation is an instrument devised under law to afford some time for introspection to both the parties to a troubled marriage. Law allows an opportunity to both the husband and the wife to think about the continuance of their relationship while at the same time directing them to live separately, thus allowing them the much needed space and independence to choose their path. Judicial separation is a sort of last resort before the actual legal breakup, that is, a legal breakup of marriage, that is, divorce. The reason for the presence of such a provision under Hindu Marriage Act is the anxiety of the legislature that the tensions and wear and tear of everyday life and the strain of living together do not result in abrupt breakup of a marital relationship. There is no effect of a decree for judicial separation on the subsistence and continuance of the legal relationship of marriage, as such, between the party. The effect, however, is on their cohabitation. Once a decree for judicial separation is passed, a husband or a wife, whosoever has approached the court, is under no obligation to live with his or her spouse. The provision for judicial separation is contained in Section 10 of the Hindu Marriage Act 1955. The section reads as under, a decree for judicial separation can be sought on all those grounds on which decree for dissolution of marriage, that is, divorce, can be sought. Hence, judicial separation can be had on any of the following grounds: adultery, cruelty, desertion, apostasy, that is, conversion of religion, insanity, virulent and incurable form of leprosy, venereal disease in a communicable form, renunciation of a world by entering any religious order, has not been heard of, has been alive for 7 years, that is also presumption of death, in case of presumption of death. If the person applying for judicial separation is the wife, then the following grounds are also available to her. Remarriage or earlier marriage of the husband but solemnized before the commencement of Hindu Marriage Act 1955, provided the other wife is alive at the time of presentation of petition for judicial separation by the petitioner's wife, rape, sodomy or bestiality by the husband committed after the solemnization of his marriage with the petitioner. Non-resumption of cohabitation between the parties till at least 1 year after an award of maintenance was made by any court against the husband and in favor of the petitioner wife. Solemnization of the petitioner's wife's marriage with respondent husband before she had attained the age of 15 years, provided she had repudiated the marriage on attaining the age of 15 years but before attaining the age of 18 years. It is on all the above grounds that judicial separation can be sought, but the first 9 grounds are available to both the parties, that is, husband and wife. But the last 4 grounds are available only to the wife. It is to be noted that it is on these grounds that divorce is also granted It has been held that unless a case for divorce is made out, the question of granting judicial separation does not arise. Therefore, the courts, while dealing with the applications for judicial separation, shall bear in mind the specific grounds raised for grant of a relief claimed and insist on strict proof to establish those grounds, and shall not grant some relief or the other as a matter of course. Thus, on a petition for a divorce, the court has a discretion in respect of the grounds for divorce, other than those mentioned in Section 13, Clause 1A, and some other grounds to grant restricted relief of judicial separation instead of divorce straight away. If it is just having regard to the facts that regards to the facts and circumstances, another question that arises is of decree of maintenance vis-a-vis decree for judicial separation, where a decree for judicial separation was obtained by the husband against her wife who had deserted him, the wife not being of unchaste character, nor her conduct being flagrantly vicious, the order of alimony made in favor of the wife was not interfered with by the court. Now, ILR 1964 to Punjab 732, the Punjab and Haryana government the Punjab and Haryana High Court has also held that a reading of Section 24 and 26 maintenance, 24 and 26, that is maintenance, does not show that if a petition under Section 9, 10, 12 and 13 is disposed of, the jurisdiction of the court to award maintenance pendant lied by an order to be passed is taken away. AR 1981 Punjab 305, 1981 Hindu LR 345, the above decisions go on to show that even where a decree for judicial separation is passed in favor of the husband, maintenance may still be awarded to a wife for judicial separation is no defense to claim for maintenance under Hindu Marriage Act. Though Section 10 of the Hindu Marriage Act does not provide any time as to how long judicial separation can last, but Section 13 of the Act provides that if there is no resumption of cohabitation between the parties 1 year after the decree for judicial separation is passed, the parties can get a decree for divorce on this ground itself. But divorce on this ground will be given only when 1 year has expired after the passing of the decree for judicial separation and not earlier. The reason for this is that 1 year is a long period of time and it provides sufficient time to the parties for reconciliation or to arrive at a decision if the parties fail to overcome their differences within this period. Then there is no fun in allowing the legality of the marriage to just linger on when, in substance, the relationship of marriage has long expired. It is to be noted, however, that if the parties do agree to resume cohabitation any time after the passing of the decree for judicial separation, they can get the decree rescinded by applying to the court. The Act does not refer to any specific ground on which a decree for judicial separation can be annulled or rescinded. Section 10, Clause 2, however, empowers the court to rescind the decree for judicial separation if it considers it just and reasonably to do so. However, the court have repeatedly warned that this power of rescission has to be exercised with great circumspection and not in a hurry, and only after satisfying themselves that it would be just and reasonable to allow such rescission. Thank you.